is open, and voices soft and sweet. From my study I see in the lamplight, descending the broad hall stair, grave Alice, laughing Allegra, and Edith with golden hair. A whisper, and then a silence. Yet I know by their merry eyes that they are plotting and planning together to take me by surprise. A sudden rush from the stairway, a sudden raid from the hall. By three doors left unguarded, they enter my castle wall. They climb up into my turret, or the arms and back of my chair. If I try to escape them, they surround me. They seem to be everywhere. They almost devour me with kisses, their arms about me entwine. Till I think of the Bishop of Bingen in his mouse tower on the Rhine. So you may know this poem, and it goes on. He talks about how he's captured his little girls in the round tower of his heart. Well, he wrote loving poems for his sons. He wrote loving poems for his friends. And he did commission the artist Eastman Johnson to do portraits of his family and his friends. Put his friends on the walls of this room. I will introduce you to some of them. Ralph Waldo Emerson is here, and Nathaniel Hawthorne, the 19th century American writers. Cornelius Felton, professor of Latin and Greek at Harvard University, did become the president of Harvard, of course. Many of Longfellow's friends are teachers at Harvard.